set up at CAN. I'm a group of Tectura Architects, and I'd like to commence this presentation by conveying my respects to the Wadawurrung people, their elders, past, present, and emerging, of which the land that they are the indigenous owners of the land that the Anam Cara House Geelong has been designed and built. It is a grassroots community that has come to us at Geelong, and this is a facility for life, liberty, illnesses, and end of life care facility that we designed on the Deakin Waurn Ponds campus. In life, and I guess in life and in death, people wish to have a choice, and as we say, 70% of people want to die at home, but only 14% do. And so what the board, made up of extraordinary committed people in Geelong, have put themselves forward to create such a facility for the people of Geelong, for everyone in Geelong and region. The concept is caring hands, so it's about the hands, and we've taken that concept to become the form of the building, and both in function and stylized in terms of the shape of the building. And the function actually does two things. One, it's on an extraordinary 2 hectares of land with southwest to the wind that comes up through the southwest through the Waurn Ponds creek that's to the south. But also it faces directly north, so we pick up all of the ESD components and literally being in touch with the environment, because the environment, the choice when you're so vulnerable and you have that life-limiting illness that you're dealing with, that you need to be able to have as much control as possible and to understand and know about the environment for your privacy, but also with community connection to family and others. The external and internal spaces across here, the courtyards to the east and to the west, allows people to actually be in much more protected zones in outside of the building, because you have to be able to get beds out there to experience. So some guests, and they're not patients, but call the people guests, wish to go out and experience the environment. It is about caring for the spiritual and nurturing the spiritual nature of human beings in terms of that dignity of the end of life contemplation with family and friends. The relationship of the built form to the context, working with the land, that is working with the contours and not against them, actually created the zones in terms of the separations of how we would actually limit the attachment in terms of the requirement to touch the land as little as it could possibly can, but it's an extraordinarily steep site and we have to get people in DDA compliance. It's a class 9A hospital, and we work very much with the Wadawurrung community and the elders to in fact put in cultural gardens and the like. We found artifacts that we worked with the archaeologists and the like through the cultural heritage management plan of the Wadawurrung. We found 65 artifacts that we have catalogued, and then we found a further 28 that we further catalogued. And so all of the land is actually has not left the site at all. So it's been a total and the materials that we've used is all part of the land in terms of the muted earth colours, dry and rust, with split face rock work in sandstone, and such that each part of the building made to human scale actually became a piece of painting internally and externally throughout, such that people can and timbers, materials of masonry, and the environment in which it sits, such that it is nurtured in a green solutogenic design principles just below the roof, so that we didn't affect the views from across the rural hills on the other side, overlooking the Cryo the water out there to the south. Yes, this is what it looks like. Interior, it's very, the public and cultural benefits to make a hospital look and feel like a residential facility at home has been extraordinary, working with infection control consultants and the entire consultant team. The guest accommodation is in the southern wing. It's in a home-like setting of 20 beds. The north wing has got all of the academic areas. It's connected to Deakin University's School of Medicine, Nursing and Allied Health, such that that knowledge about end-of-life care needs to be enhanced in our community, particularly in Australia, as the population also is ageing and we've had a modern lifestyle, which unfortunately makes these things happen. So there are cubbies. This is the north building, so most of the infrastructure there, the academic areas, the main entry, the respite areas where people come from the community, all the clinical spaces, so doctors, etc. Clinical spaces are there. And these are the absolute private zones with interspersed with living spaces in between through here, interconnected with a link with a pavilion of library and spaces in the east address so that the sunrise piece gets picked up, the sun travels across there and the sunsets are beautiful. So it's a spiritual and sensory rooms allowing for quiet reflection. It's a meeting place, but we're also looking after the staff with areas for staff facilities there that are incredibly stressful. Dying hospice, the integration of allied disciplines with artists, with local artists, but also with the team, but also local artists putting in the Australian flora and fauna into the building such that there are connections, lots and lots of timber, and all the medical gear is hidden away in terms of the systems that we need, and it just is trying to make it. And the Wadawurrung have been amazing, and the entire community has raised most of the money with state and federal government funding. Budget considerations have been an extraordinary consideration. I mean, the cost of the building is around $5,300 a square metre. The Deakin University, the previous Vice-Chancellor, the current one, have been terrific in support because they've gifted the land on a long-term lease. It's 2 hectares of land over a 45-year plus lease arrangement. And obviously there is also research facilities that are intertwined within the facility. And that's the Deakin University campus, and that's where the site is at the moment. Sustainability include a whole lot of...
I'm going to have to ask you to stop talking, if that's okay, and we'll just go through your slides and ask you some questions.
Okay.
I'm just asking a question around, I think you mentioned having in mind working with the contours of the site. Mm-hmm. Just interested that there seems a potential contradiction with that in terms of the car park.
Yeah.
It looks like there's some significant cut and sort of battered slope.
Yeah.
Just interested to know, there's a little bit of paradox there maybe in what you're saying, but also why would you not consider sort of terracing and getting optimal views as well through the orientation and setting of the building?
It's to do with the recurrent cost as well and setting up ramps within the building. So the entirety of the service road that's there at the site is across here. So we have to get people from here, and it's a very steep slope of 7 metres. And so what we've done is we've taken, in working with the land, we've created a space where you can get through DDA compliance throughout the facility. Because if you terrace it, you then have set up with ramps in between the terrace, and then you need to have staffing potentially to be able to deal with that because you're disconnected from the staffing ratio. So there are many considerations, and the recurrent cost of these buildings within 4 or 5 years outweigh the capital cost of a health service, which is what this is.
Yeah. Just the scale of some of those, particularly the sort of the communal living room, you mentioned it's sort of broken down into sort of smaller groups, but some of them seem to be very high, one of those living rooms and kitchens and things. Given they're broken down into sort of segments of smaller groups, How many people occupy them, and what's the scale?
These are about 26 to 28 square metres of bedroom with an ensuite. So they are for also showering facilities. So they're
also I'll just direct the living rooms, the ones with
this
the storage.
One,
yeah.
This one, yes, yes. They break up, basically these are homes within living and dining and living spaces with external areas. So they basically break up this home or pot, and then this one breaks up this one, and then so that it's broken up into, and with the Wadawurrung, and with, you know, it's going to provide services for families that can come and stay within the rooms themselves.